All the animals, they eat raw food, and it is only the man who cook his food in addition to eating some in the raw form. There are a lot of the edible fruits like that of the apple, plum, oranges, they are eaten raw. Lot of grain and pulses, we used to cook it before they are consumed as a food. Out of this, there are some grains and pulses, they are eaten raw. How? They are eaten in a sprouted form. Sprout. What is the meaning of the sprout? You can see here, when a seed begins to grow by developing a tiny root, you can see a white color is there, white thing that is coming out of a seed, it is actually showing the germination or the beginning of the growing of the seed by developing the tiny roots in it. And they are known as sprouts. Sprouts. The value of some type of a seed can be increased by converting them into sprout. These are the grains. When they become sprout, they contain more and more amount of nutrition in it. Like this, sprouts contain vitamin A, B and C, and making this food more nutritious. There is a method of making sprout from the seed, and that is known as sprouting. So sprouting is a process by which the seed begins to grow. In Hindi we called sprout or sprouting is a ankuran ya ankurit. So these are the seeds you can see here. This is a moong or a green gram. We call it a green gram. The moong, it is germinated, it is sprout. So we can say in Hindi, ankurit moong ki dal. So how can we prepare this sprout? So we can take a 50 gram of a seed of a green gram or that of the Bengal gram, that is the chana, in a vessel containing the water and keep it overnight. Next day you will remove the seed from the water and wrap the seed in the piece of a wet cloth. Again you will keep it aside for one day, and water it should be sprinkled so that the moisture should be there in the cloth. After that, after 24 hours, when you open the wrap of the cloth, then you will see a tiny white structure have been grown out of the seed. And then we can say the seeds have sprouted or sprouts have been formed. These sprouts can be boiled and eaten as a snack after adding salt and spices. This is an activity for the sprouting of the seed. And you can see that we have taken a two type of a gram, that is a green gram, which is also known as moong ki dal, and Bengal gram, that is chana. After washing it, both of them, we will add the water in it. And keep it aside for overnight so that it will soak the water. After soaking the water, again we will wash it. And with the help of a cloth, we will keep it aside. Sprinkling of the water is important so that the moisture will be there. If moisture will be there, then the process of the germination will be easily, or it will be possible to germinate. When we talk about the germination, it means we are talking about the sprouting. A food, a seed is, if it is sprouted, it means it is ready for the germination. It germinates. When you open it after 12 to 13 hours, then you will see the white thing that comes out from the gram. It actually showing the sprouting. So by this activity, we are able to understand the sprouting. The eating habits of animal. And when we talk about the eating habits of animal, it means that what animal eat. Before that, we should know that from where these animal obtain food. So they obtain food either from the animals or from the plants. So we should know the meaning of a producer. Producer, yes. The plants, they do not eat food like the animals do. Because animal, they get their food either by eating the other animals or they eat plant. But the plants, they do not eat food or they do not take food from that of the animals. They make their food by its own. And the green plants which produces their or which make their food, that process is known as photosynthesis. So that's why the plants are called as a producers. You can see here that they do this process of photosynthesis by using the light energy from the sun, carbon dioxide from the air and water from the soil to produce food. After this photosynthesis, the food they prepared, actually it is in the form of a glucose or sugar. That's why we called that all plants, they make their own food and they are called as a food producer. And all the green plant, since they perform photosynthesis, they are known as a producer or the food producer. They provide food to the animals, including human being. For example, we eat chapati, rice, noodle, everything. So we are actually eating the food made and stored by the plant. Now we will come to the consumer. Animals. The animals only consume food made by others, that is by the plant or the other animals. That's why the animals, they are known as consumer. So all the animals, including human being also, they are food consumer. Now we will go to our previous topic, that is how do these animals, they get their food, they obtain their food. So since animals, they cannot make their own food, so they depend on the ready-made food, and this food come either from the plant or from the animals. So animal that obtain their food from the plant or the other animals, including the human beings also. And on the basis of their food habit, the animals are divided into three groups, that is the herbivore, carnivores and omnivore. So we will start with the herbivore. Some animals, they eat only plant or their products. And those animals which eat only plant and the plant material, they are known as herbivore. So herbivore, they may eat grass, they may eat leaves, grain, fruits or the bark of the tree. And the examples of the herbivore are goat, cow, rabbit is there, elephant is there, buffalo, sheep, horse, deer, giraffe, butterfly, parrot, hippopotamus, these all are the examples of the herbivore. Herbivores are also known as herbivorous animals. herbivorous animals. Now see the next one, that is the carnivorous. Some of the animals are there which eat only other animals, and they do so, they do not eat plant food at all. Those animals which eat only other animal as food, they are known as the carnivore. So we can define carnivore as that the carnivore are the animals which eat only the meat of other animals. A lot of examples are there, like that of the lion, that of the tiger or wolf. Or the wolf. Okay. Lion is a carnivore because it eats only the meat or the flesh of the other animals. Next one is the omnivore. Omnivore. Some animals, they eat, before that we talk about the herbivore and the carnivore. In herbivore, the animals, they eat only plant. In carnivore, the animal eat only the other animals or the flesh of the other animals. Omnivore are those which eat both plants as well as animal as food. And those animals which eat both plants and animals are known as omnivore. Some of the examples of the omnivore are dog, cat, crow, ant is there, bear, and human being. Yes, human being, it is a human being is called an omnivore because he eat the plant food, we eat the vegetables, fruits, and grains, as well as the meat of the animal like goat, chicken, and fish. So omnivore, they are the plant eater. They are the plant eaters as well as meat or flesh eater. Omnivores are also known as omnivorous animals. So, the animals are basically divided into herbivorous, carnivorous, and omnivorous. Out of herbivore, carnivores, and omnivore, there is another term, that is scavenger. Scavengers are the animals. That animals, they are fond of eating dead and the decaying plants or animal body. So they collect and carry the dead or the left out food to their place so that they can use that food for the future use. A lot of examples are there of scavengers. We can understand scavenger in a very simple language that scavengers are the animals which eat the dead and the decaying plants or animal body. A lot of examples of the scavengers like that of the vulture, hyena, crow is there, crow, ants. Ants are best serving as a scavenger. They carry every bit of food including the dead insect, and this way they clean the surrounding and serves as a scavenger. Vulture, they are the carnivorous animals as well as they feed on the flesh of the dead and the decaying animals, and in this way they also act as the scavengers. Scavengers plays a very important role in the surrounding because it help in cleaning our environment or our surrounding.